Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Honigberg. I'm a cardiologist at the Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts. Today, we'll be talking about a topic that's fundamental to the practice of medicine, blood pressure. Specifically, we'll be covering the definition and diagnosis of hypertension as outlined in the 2017 American College of Cardiology, American Heart Association guidelines for the management of blood pressure. Our objectives today will be for you to understand how to perform proper technique for measuring blood pressure, correctly apply the 2017 ACC-AHA guidelines to diagnose and classify hypertension, and review the concepts of white coat hypertension and masked hypertension. When the heart pumps blood through the arteries, the blood puts pressure on the artery walls. This is known as blood pressure. Blood pressure is reported as two numbers, both in units of millimeters of mercury. The top number is the systolic blood pressure, representing pressure when the heart is ejecting blood into the arterial system. The bottom number is the diastolic blood pressure, representing pressure when the heart is relaxing, diastole. Complications of high blood pressure include ischemic heart disease, including myocardial infarction, stroke, peripheral artery disease, aortic aneurysm and dissection, heart failure, and chronic kidney disease. On a global scale, elevated blood pressure is the most common risk factor for death and disability worldwide. Correct measurement of blood pressure is important when evaluating and managing patients. First, prepare. Ideally, the patient should have an empty bladder and not have consumed caffeine or exercised within the last 30 minutes. The patient should sit supported for at least 5 minutes with feet on the floor and back well supported. Measure the blood pressure correctly. Ensure the correct cuff size and that 80% of the cuff's bladder fits around the patient's upper arm. The cuff should sit on bare skin. No talking during measurement of the blood pressure. Measure blood pressure in both arms and use the higher reading to guide medical decision making. If the blood pressure is elevated, repeat measurement after at least 1 to 2 minutes. Now you've measured your patient's blood pressure, how do you interpret the readings? The 2017 ACC-AHA guidelines define hypertension as a systolic blood pressure greater than or equal to 130 millimeters of mercury, or a diastolic blood pressure greater than or equal to 80 millimeters of mercury. The guidelines further define four categories of blood pressure: normal, elevated, stage 1 hypertension, and stage 2 hypertension, indicating more severe hypertension. Stage 2 is defined as a systolic blood pressure greater than or equal to 140 millimeters of mercury, or a diastolic blood pressure greater than or equal to 90 millimeters of mercury. The guidelines further endorse the use of blood pressure measured outside the office to confirm a diagnosis of hypertension in some patients and to monitor response to treatment. A couple of different options are available for out-of-office blood pressure measurement. The terminology here can be a little bit confusing. Home blood pressure monitoring typically refers to self-measurement of blood pressure by the patient using a validated device. Ambulatory blood pressure monitoring, by contrast, refers to measurement of out-of-office blood pressures using a temporary monitor prescribed by the physician or clinician that monitors the blood pressure regularly at set intervals, such as every 30 or 60 minutes, over a period of 24 hours. As summarized in this table included in the guidelines, it's expected that blood pressures measured in the office might be a little bit higher on average than blood pressures measured at home. And so thresholds for normal and elevated blood pressures differ depending on in-office versus out-of-office measurement. Note as well that nighttime ambulatory blood pressures tend to be lower on average than daytime ambulatory blood pressures. So how do we put all these numbers together? If a patient has normal blood pressures both in the office and in the out-of-office setting, they are called normotensive. If a patient has hypertension both in the office setting and in the non-healthcare setting, they have what we call sustained hypertension. But what if there's discordance? White coat hypertension refers to the situation where a patient has elevated blood pressures in the office but normal blood pressures on out-of-office measurement. Again, this is called white coat hypertension. It's worth noting that a recent meta-analysis suggested that untreated white coat hypertension is associated with excess cardiovascular disease risk compared to patients with solid normotension. So this is a population not to be ignored who may benefit from additional monitoring or lifestyle interventions. We'll talk more about the management of elevated blood pressure in another section. Finally, masked hypertension refers to a situation where a patient has normal blood pressures measured in the office, but true hypertension outside the office. This condition is associated with the same excess risk of cardiovascular disease as sustained hypertension and merits treatment. In summary, in this video, we learned how to perform proper technique for measuring blood pressure, how to apply the 2017 ACC/AHA guidelines to correctly diagnose and classify degree of hypertension, and reviewed the concepts of white coat hypertension and masked hypertension. Thank you for watching today. I hope you found this video educational.